He's the best known and the most recognized name in pool, the incomparable Steve the Miz Mizerak. His game is back in top form, and he's back in the semifinals of the Pro Tour Championship. And he's in against one of the best players in the world, EFREN REYES of the Philippines. The magician, he's called. And he's the current eight-ball champion and in the running for Player of the Year honors. Tonight, from Owensboro, Kentucky, these two star players meet in a semifinal match with the winner to advance to the finals of the Pro Tour Championship.
What a very nice reception as we greet you from Owensboro, Kentucky, and welcome you to some serious pool, the Pro Tour Championship semifinal competition. I'm Tom Kelly, surrounded by champions, Buddy Hall to my right, and Owensboro's own pride and joy, Nick Varner. It's great to have them with us, and they'll provide the expertise on our telecast. Gentlemen, a week ago, we saw one of the great semifinal matches. I tell you, Davenport and Charles, and 11-10, what a great match.
Oh, that was a wonderful match. 9-2, then 10-4, and then 11-10.
And you know, we talked, Nick, about what kind of mental toughness it takes for a guy to sit there on that chair, and he's down 9-2, and then 10-5, and still fight his way back to get the win.
Well, I think that's why they call this hardball serious pool on the Pro Billiards Tour.
It truly is. I don't know if our match tonight is going to live up to it, but I tell you, the two men you're going to watch have certainly got the talent to do it. Steve Mizerak and EFREN REYES, the magician. Mizerak, I think, is the most recognizable face and form in all of pool. He's a magnificent player, and it's good to have him back in top form.
Yeah, it's really great, Tom, to see him playing great, and I know he's really looking forward to this match, and he's really got a beautiful game to watch.
All right, you've known the Miz for a long time. He can really play this game, can't he?
You have good players, then you have top players, then you have great players. Mizerak is one of the great players.
He's going to have to be at his very best to beat Reyes, because many people think Reyes might be the best player in the world.
Well, right now, he's certainly proven it this year, Tom.
Eight-ball champion, and he's been in almost every show we've done, hasn't he?
Yeah, he's the number one player in our Pro Billiards Tour, so that pretty well speaks for itself.
Well, we had a great match a week ago. If these two guys can live up to that, it'll be some kind of a show. Glad you joined us from Owensboro. We'll be back to get it underway in just a moment. All right, here's the lag now. Conceivably the most important shot in all of pool. The man who can put the cue ball nearest to the railing. It is quite obvious that Steve Mizerak has done that, and he will get the first break. And the first break, getting the break. And that is the most important thing. Here are the rules that govern play. We're in semifinal competition in this Pro Tour Championship. They lagged for the break, as you just saw a moment ago. Balls are shot in numerical order. The ball in hand on all fouls. Push-out option after the break. We'll explain that if and when it occurs. Three consecutive fouls, the loss of the rack. Player who pockets the nine ball wins the rack, and the race is to 11. Whoever gets to 11 first is the winner. And now Steve Mizerak will be the man to play first, and we'll sit back and watch one of the best that pool has ever seen. Oops, off the table. So that'll be ball in hand for EFREN REYES.
Wow, scratching the break, it's ball in hand anywhere on the table.
And the table is pretty well spread out, gentlemen, is it not?
Yeah, there could. When he goes from that four to that five ball, that five's tucked a little bit under the eight ball. That looks to be where there might be a little problem with this rack.
Reyes is the type of player that you cannot give an opportunity to.
Maybe.
He extremely difficult. He's called the magician. Outstanding players from the Philippines. Working on the two ball in the corner. He's got the three ball back in the other end. Five ball down in the corner here. Nine ball is down toward the bottom of the, right down there.
So four to the five is tough, isn't it, buddy?
Yes, it is. Four to the five is real tough.
Scott Smith is our referee. He'll be seen from time to time conversing with the players.
Okay, we have the four ball right here. The five is here. He's going to have to come up and stay in this area. He's got to stay inside of the eight ball there.
Cuts the four in beautifully, and oh, great. My.
He's in good shape.
Is he?
Yeah.
He has room for the five ball up against the rail.
Where does he go for the six here now?
I believe he's going to have to come right across. He's going to come across and maybe back.
It looks like he can't bump the eight because he might end up behind the eight.
Right, I think he's going to shoot the five right down in here. Bring the cue ball back out into this area here. Well, he went to that area, but he didn't take as long a route as I was pointing out.
Man, he was almost dangerously close to being behind that eight ball, wasn't he?
You think he's going to shoot this at a soft speed here, buddy?
Well, that's what makes this shot awfully hard, is having to hit it soft.
That is a hard shot there.
Boy, he has a touch, doesn't he?
That was a great shot.
Seven in the corner, no problem.
Yeah, Ephraim's a beautiful player to watch. He's got such great rhythm.
And the eight. Remember, Steve Mizerak had the break and scratched the cue ball off the table, ball in hand. And Reyes, just one more shove away from taking the opening rack. And he does just that. So Reyes leads one game to none, and now he will have the cue in hand for the second rack, and he'll have the opportunity to break.
We're going out to how many countries are we going out to?
I don't know. Quite a few. Yeah. I know there are millions of people across the country that are watching you great players.
I think we're even going to the Philippines.
Could be.
Yeah,
I tell you, pool is a big-time item in the Philippines, thanks largely, I guess, to this young man and his fellow players.
Well, also, there's a company over there and a gentleman called Jose Poyot, and he's really a great fan and sponsor of the sport. And in fact, right now, the Pro Billiards Tour is in negotiation with bringing an event to the Philippines, and I know Jose's involved with that. And he'll be trying to put that together. And the Filipino team that's here in America playing on the Pro Billiards Tour told me to tell Jose Poyot hello. And on behalf of the Pro Billiards Tour, I'd like to tell our friends in Manila, Jose Poyot, hello from the Pro Billiards Tour.
Yeah. That's great. Now, Miz, has he got a shot for the one ball here? Is he going to try to make the six or what?
Well, it looks like he's going to play safe. It was either play safe or try to bank it one rail across. Yeah. He elected to play safe.
So Steve Mizerak, down one game to none, gives the ball to, or the cue, to our friend Reyes.
You have the one ball right here. The cue ball is in this area right here. He has to figure out a way to hit this. I think he's going to come one. He's going to come straight down one, two, and kick the one back up this way, trying to stick the cue ball in the area where the one ball's at right now.
Return the favor. In other words, don't leave the Miz
right.
A shot either. Huh?
Right.
Steve Mizerak is trying to put together a senior tour. Some of you older guys, eh, buddy?
Yeah, some of us youngsters get to play on it.
He told me to come out and play, and I said they took all my milk money years ago. That's a bad hit. He caught the three ball. It was not a clean hit, so it's going to be ball
Mizerak
in hand for the Miz. You don't see Reyes make too many mistakes like that, Nick, huh?
No.
Careless or just a bad shot or what?
Well, he just came a little too short and hit the three, but that's part of the game that's kind of made him famous in America, is his kicking game. When he came over, it really heightened the awareness of how important it is when you're kicking, because he escapes many a time on shots like that, doesn't he, buddy?
Yes, he does. Here, I believe he'll just try to go into the five. He's going to try to play the one straight in here and let the cue ball bump the five out of the way for the two.
Did that. Well, I love the two in the same pocket and follow it a little bit for the three down in the corner.
Well, Steve's been a great straight pool player, and that's kind of a straight pool shot there where you bump balls out of the way. He won four U.S. Opens in a row.
But you know, the man is truly a legend. I mean, there isn't much in this game he hasn't done, and he has been away from the limelight. I mean, from the television cameras, in tournaments like this for a while, his health has not been all that good, and his game hasn't really been that good. Now it's back.
All right.
Although he says he's got a terrible back. His back bothers him.
Well, Steve's been doing a lot of work here for the last two or three years. He hasn't really devoted the time to his game that he'd like to. Mm-hmm. But now he's decided he's going to go ahead and give it a shot and play a little bit. And here's proof of the pudding. He's playing great.
Yeah.
Well, he has such a beautiful stroke. Seems like he can get so much on the cue ball with so little effort.
Well, he's got the table set here to even this one apiece. He'll take the seven right down in the corner, huh? And stop the cue ball there for the eight in the other corner and then follow it a little bit for the nine, huh?
I think so.
He could follow down for the side pocket here.
Is it?
No, you no, called it. He's playing the corner.
Then he'll put the eight down here, I believe, won't he, gentlemen? I would think, yeah.
Yes.
And then the nine in the other pocket across.
You're starting to learn this game, Tom.
Oh, I'm just living proof that little knowledge is dangerous. So the Miz comes back to even it up. We're tied at a game apiece here in the semifinal of the Pro Tour Championship. We'll be back. Games are tied at one apiece now, and the Miz, Steve Mizerak, with the break. Last time he broke, why, cue ball went on the floor, and Reyes ran the table on him.
You can bet he'll make an adjustment on this break. Still cut it a little bit, didn't he, buddy?
Yes, he did. Put the eight ball in the corner, though.
He hit it with a good level stroke. Here we have the one ball. The two ball is this ball right here. This is the cue ball. What he has to do is he has to hit this shot and make the cue ball slow down enough in order to play position for the two in this side. This is a very hard shot here. He has to slow the ball down.
Or do you try to go four rails here?
Well, a lot of traffic.
Yeah.
Well, you called it, Nicky. Three rails.
Gotta get a break. He did.
What a great shot was. That was just magnificent there.
Now you put the two ball up in the far right-hand corner.
Look at how good a position he got on that two ball. That was a really hard shot.
He has a problem with the four.
Look at that stroke. Look at that stroke. That is power there.
Now he's got the four. Five. What's his problem with the four, buddy?
Well, he's got to play position on the five, and he's looking to see where he's going to go. And
can he come off those two rails and be right out there again, or can he? Can he come up there and there and come back out? Got to hit it a little harder, a little more?
Perfect.
What's wrong with that?
Perfection, and it was perfect.
He's even got the nice little angle where he can just roll down a little bit.
Well, then what does he do? Does he play the 6-9 combination? Oh, no, I see. All right, okay.
Did he get far enough?
He may have.
Yeah, I think the 6 is dead in, isn't it?
Now, he may have an angle to where he can touch this rail with the cue ball.
Yeah, I think he's going to draw it in.
6 straight in. He's got to try to draw it back and touch this rail or just stick right there in that area. He wants to get closer to it. Oh, he followed it.
Needs a little hurry up on it. Needs
what a nice hurry. Speed.
Yeah, all right, good.
Tell you what, he's made a nice out here, buddy. If he gets the 7-9 in, which it looks like it's pretty well routine now, but boy, that's a great rack here. That's a confidence builder, this rack point.
I would imagine, and we should talk about that a little bit, as magnificent a player as he is and as magnificent as he has been, his heart's got to be pumping just a little bit quicker than that. Beautiful run by the Miz. Mizerak makes it 2-1 now. Handled the cue and the ball's on the table beautifully, and he'll be back to break the rack again. He still feels the pressure, doesn't he? Huh?
Oh, absolutely. Oh,
everybody feels it. If they say they don't, they're not telling the truth.
Yeah, they aren't paying attention. They aren't paying attention. You're watching semifinal competition, the Pro Tour Championship. We're in Owensboro, Kentucky, on the banks of the beautiful Ohio. Nick Varner's town, and some of the knowledgeable, very attentive pool fans looking on. Here's the break from the Miz.
Yeah, it's great to play in this tournament in my hometown and be able to sleep in my own bed at night.
Isn't that nice? That is nice. Can I make the...
I believe he's okay.
Yep.
Looks like the key here is when he playing position from the three to the four, buddy.
Right. He's got to come out here for the three ball in this corner pocket. Now, the four is laying right here. It looks like the only available pocket is there for the four.
That's so where the eight is, isn't it? Oh, I see, played the other way. Right. Put the three back up there, and does he draw the cue ball back for the four?
No, no. He played the right angle. He'll just come off the side here and to the side rail and back down this area here for the four in this pocket.
Yeah, he's got the perfect angle to do that.
And he's got that eight ball down in the corner pocket.
He's got to be careful.
Yes, he does.
He's kind of caught in a trap here.
Yeah,
he needs to bend
bit.
Over to reach it.
That's right. And there's a lot, let's be honest, there's a lot of Steve to bend over. Look, he's kind of grinning about it. Maybe a little late for that, Miz. You may have heard me say that. This is not an easy shot for the big fella. He touches that eight ball, fouls it anyway, well, it'll be ball in hand for Reyes.
That eight ball's making this a tough shot instead of an easy shot, isn't it?
Yeah, it really is. He's got to be worried about it. No, he's well clear of that now, if he can just settle down and realize that. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful.
He's glad that shot's over with.
Yeah, and you want to know something? Because my voice carries, I realize that, and I'm glad that he made that because he kind of stepped away from that shot when I said that it might be a little late for him to brush that off. So I'm glad it all worked out for him.
I think he's got to go between the 9 and 8 here. Oh.
Him to do that.
I don't think so.
I didn't like that.
No. He's left himself a real hard shot on this five.
Yeah.
He'll probably play it in that left corner and have the cue ball just bounce off the right rail and play the six on the side. But just he's mostly interested in concentrating on pocketing the five ball here.
That's the first business by him, way up in the corner on the left. What a great camera shot that is. Beautifully.
Boy, he's playing good,
anybody.
Yeah. He's playing good.
He's pocketing balls good.
That went right in the center of the hole.
Now, buddy, the eight ball right down here, does that give him any kind of a problem with the nine ball being there?
What it does, he has to strike this rail and come back over. So the only thing he has to really worry about is his speed, his cue ball speed. He's in good shape, I believe.
Yep, beautiful. Now, for a left-hander, that's not the easiest of shots. He's going to have to go get the bridge, isn't he?
Right. He has his own bridge. He brings it with him. He likes it because he can maneuver it around, stretch it out. And very lightweight. Just bump the end rail, come up, play the nine in the same pocket.
Beautiful. Beautifully done. So it would appear that the Miz is going to take a 3-1 advantage in games over EFREN Reyes. Nicely done. The Miz goes up 3-1. He leads in games here in the semifinal competition. Watch again as he buries that five ball, beautifully played all the way up to the corner in great position on the six, and from there he ran the rack, and we'll be back. So the semifinal competition continues. Steve Mizerak, the Miz, up 3-1 over EFREN Reyes, the magician, and it's Mizerak at the table for still another break. And with Nick Varner and Buddy Hall, I'm Tom Kelly here on Prime from Owensboro, Kentucky. And the Miz is playing every bit as good as advertised. He's really showing some clever manipulation of cue and ball. Needs a break. Not going to get one here. Well, came up empty, huh?
Sure did.
Well, you hit him hard, too. And square.
And so Reyes now comes to the four, and he's got both the cue ball and the one ball at that end of the table. What kind of a shot has he got in that one ball, buddy?
Well, it doesn't
if
have
any,
much.
Huh?
He may be able to bank the one out here and bring the cue ball down into this area right here.
I mean, you're talking, if it goes in, great, but let's just play it safe, huh?
Yeah, I believe he's going to have to play safe.
Both of you men competed in this tournament that is in its semifinal stage and played well. Neither one of you played the magician, huh? Did you play Reyes, Nick Martin?
No, I didn't play him.
Did you, buddy? You didn't have to play
him
either.
No.
Well, he's kind of, has he given the Miz a headache or two here?
Yes.
Well, it does look like it's
tough,
doesn't it?
He only has one shot that I can see.
Lay it out for us there.
Okay, I believe he's going to have to bring the cue ball all the way down to the end rail and back to the one in order to hit it. He may curve his, but he's going to curve his ball. Okay, he's going to curve his cue ball.
Beautiful.
Oh, great shot.
Beautiful. Got a bad kiss there. Yeah. Got a bad kiss. Well, he'd have had that one ball buried and the cue ball back down behind the three, and he got a bad bounce, didn't he?
Right, he had to make his cue ball go around the two. We call it curving our rock.
Well, the Miz has gotten most of those shots.
Yeah, I believe he's just going to play this ball across the side. And this is the ball that he has to play position on. I believe it does pass the seven, so I believe he'll just shoot this across the side. No, he's ducking. Evidently, the two won't go.
You might cut it at the end down there. Is that a shot? Is that unbelievable? I mean, how thin? I've seen delicatessens don't cut meat that thin. I mean, even though they try. Huh? That's amazing.
Well, I can't believe he cut it down the corner when all he had to do is shoot and stop banking it.
But what is it?
There's no reason for that. No.
Can he get the two ball past everything down?
Yeah, it goes past the seven, I believe.
He's got a little bit of a problem here, going from the two to the three, then the three to the four, and then the four to the five. That's a real tricky combination of four balls there.
Right, he has to play the two in here. He has to play position.
And he did. Or did he?
Yeah, he's got
great position here. Boy, what a nice. He really
Well, how does he move the five away from the nine ball?
He has to make sure that he's right against the rail with the cue ball. He shoots the three, and he's got to lay right against the side rail.
He's got the four all the way back up in the corner.
Right, he has to be dead straight in on the four.
Isn't this your four up here with the four ball?
Yes.
Here? Yeah, and then, but he has to break up this combination, doesn't he? No.
He doesn't have to break it up. He just wants to fall close to the rail. Well, no, he's doing something different.
He must be going to go three rails at it.
Yeah.
Or play his cue ball over to here.
Well, he showed us a beautiful cut shot a moment ago. There's no reason to believe he can't cut that in the corner. And he does. Now, how about, can he make the five where it is?
Yeah.
Huh? Slip it past the nine, huh? Man, that cut shot back in the corner, that was... You know, that pocket has been a problem. A week ago, we saw... Both Davenport and Archer, they just got more rim rattlers in that corner pocket. As you watch Reyes, and working on the six ball, cuts it back in, comes back perfectly for the seven ball. He beat Harriman and Kennedy and Morris and Wetch and Rempe, and that's a pretty good run. So taking it to the semifinals, and now he's just put the eight ball on the side and the nine ball, and we're going to have it down to 3-2 in games here in this first race to 11.
Well, you can bet all the TVs in the Philippines are wired to this match right here.
And he does it. It is now 3-2 in favor of the Miz. And EFREN REYES, the magician, eight ball champion currently. He won the U.S. Open nine ball a year ago, 94, defended that title quite well earlier in the series.
Well, since he won the U.S. Open last year in September, he's had an unbelievable
great
run.
Great string, unbelievable. Yeah, he won the nine ball and then he lost out to the young man from Jackson, Mississippi, Reed Pierce. What a great match that was. And he has been very, very tough on the tour. This guy can play, make no mistake about it. Here he is now, down 3-2. It's his break. It was a nine ball hanging right on the edge. Ooh-wee. One ball is gone, the two ball is up on the other side, and the three ball.
And play the two ball in here. This is the three right here. It will go in the side pocket. The four ball is laying over against this side rail, so I don't really know. He'll have to play it down the opposite corner. He played a perfect angle. He's just going to bring his cue ball right to the side rail, play the four all the way down.
If he gets to the six ball, gentlemen, with the cue ball up at that end of the table, we can go to a new rack. You agree with me?
Yeah, I think I played a 6-9 combination. Mm-hmm. What do you think,
buddy? I do, too.
Well, it depends on where he lands.
Well, if he has the cue ball up there, and it would appear he's going to, because he's got the 5 ball next, that'd be in perfect position. I don't think he goes by the 6. I think that's the last of it.
Got to be a little careful here. Oh, he's going opposite-handed. He's going left-handed with this shot.
Is that something? I mean, this guy.
Left or right-handed?
He'd probably take his shoes off and play pretty good, too.
No, he's a switch hitter.
You think he'll bank the 6 off the rail or no. Shoot it straight into it?
I think he's going right into the 9. Didn't I call that about 4 balls ago? Didn't I say that? We're deadlocked at 3 apiece. All right, Reyes comes back. He and the Miz are deadlocked at 3 apiece as you watch him now with a replay of a shot and sets it up perfectly for the 6. And follows, puts the 9 ball in the corner, and wins the rack.
You're turning to a technician on this pool.
Almost. All right, we're deadlocked at 3 apiece. Well, we're back on service. If this indeed were a tennis match, you'd say that. Reyes and Mizerak each has given away one of the racks, and they're dead even at 3 apiece. Here's Reyes now. He's come back to catch Mizerak after being 3-1.
We hit those square.
Boy, does it. 2-3 balls.
Cue ball never even hit a rail.
Boy.
Boy, look at this layout. Mm-hmm. I'd like to play these myself, buddy.
I might be able to play those, Nick. Wait a minute. If it's that easy, let me do it once.
I believe you just shoot the two in here, strike the side rail, bring it back over here.
Get the three ball sitting right in the middle of the pocket.
For the three ball right here.
Unbelievable. What a break. Reyes looking to take a 4-3 lead. He's called the magician. Both men have played beautifully. Each has had one miscue. That is where they allowed the other to get on the table. And they've each taken advantage of it. Now Reyes looks to go ahead in what has been a 3-3 contest. Semifinal competition. We're in Owensboro, Kentucky. Just south of Indiana. Northern city here in Kentucky on the banks of the Ohio. Nick Varner, Owensboro's pride and joy, sitting next to me. He was in the tournament, and Buddy Hall, the rifleman, one of the two veteran champion players of this game. He's got a little place that he's opening up down in Tampa, Florida. Come by and play 9 ball with him one of these days.
When are you going to have that open, Buddy?
Well, it's really open now. Things are starting to pick up pretty good. It's a new business of mine called Hot Shots. I'd like to say hello to everybody down there, too.
Good. We wish you great success with it. Very nice. Boy, I tell you, you know, this guy doesn't... He made one careless shot a while ago when he gave the Miz the ball in hand. But since then, he seldom makes a mistake, does he? He is awfully tough. And the Miz looks at him and says, I think his face probably mirrors what we were saying. This kid can play. And make no mistake about it, out of an occasional miscue, why Reyes, tough to fault. Reyes leads 4-3 as you look at the stats. Balls pocketed, almost even. I mean, considering them playing, balls missed, no. Scratches on the break, one by the Miz. Kicking errors, one by Reyes. Those were the two miscues I spoke of. And the rest of it has been, look at the statistics.
Yeah, 971. That's out of a possible perfect 1,000. And look at Mizerak, 964.
Yes.
I mean, that's close to perfect pool.
They have played excellent. And each has made a mistake. Each has capitalized on it. And Reyes now leading 4-3 has the break.
Table's leaking.
Huh? Are you kidding? It's almost like somebody threw a hand grenade in the middle of the ball's flying in pockets everywhere.
Look at these. 1, 4, 5, 6, 9.
Yep.
It's not much to this rack.
Mm-hmm.
Just got to make sure he gets to the end rail or all the way back one.
This is even easier than the last rack. It was such a great break.
Is that a beautifully played cue ball there when he laid that right against the rail, buddy?
Yeah, he's...
I mean, it gives him perfect position for the shot, doesn't it?
He plays great position. He plays the cue ball very well. He used to play a lot of billiards, and that helps his cue ball as far as playing position.
Oh, he just got such power on speed control.
Well, we're not going to fool around here. I'm going to call it again, fellas. He's going to play this combination and put the nine ball away. Hello. Hello.
This combination's down pat.
Old sure thing, Kelly. Well, Reyes has taken a 5-3 lead now in the race to 11. Remember, the winner of 11 games will go on to play the championship against Kim Davenport, young man who a week ago you saw him battle Archer in 11-10, come from a 9-2 deficit, a 10-4, 10-5 deficit, to beat Archer 11-10.
What an exciting match that was.
It truly was a great match. And both men played brilliantly, beautifully. And in fact, some of the fans were muttering after the game, you know, Archer didn't really lose it. Davenport just won it.
That's right.
That's the kind of a match it was. Well, Reyes again.
He may have come up dry that time.
And he may have scratched. No, he didn't. Oh.
He corner hooked him.
Oh, boy.
He corner hooked him.
And the Miz is saying, a fine thing. This is.
Yeah, he caught a lucky break there, huh, buddy?
Yes, he did, Miz. Miz is not a happy camper right at the minute.
No. He has, there's no way to get that shot and hit the one ball. Right?
No, I don't believe there's any way for him to hit it.
What did he run, four racks in a row there?
Yes, yeah. It was 1-1.
He ran four racks.
Ran four.
This is the cue ball right here. This is the one. He is actually blocked by this point right here.
Yep.
He can't even hit the one. I don't know what he's got. He has to push out.
But if he does and really gives Reyes a problem, Reyes may say, go ahead and play it, Steve, huh? Yep. That's the problem with it.
Right. It's just...
This is a legal push-out.
That's about the best he
Reyes
could do.
Reyes has the option.
Ephraim's got a pretty good shot. He can either play safe or he can play that ball cross corner.
Yeah, he's going to try to hook him. He's just going to bank the one over to this area and bring the cue ball down this area right here to play safe.
You got it on the button, buddy.
Yeah, buddy, and I tell you.
Perfect call.
It's amazing control of that cue ball. I mean, that thing could have stopped anywhere in here, and instead it just drifted back down and out of sight, huh?
Yeah.
That's amazing. Well, what about, can he bank it off here and hit it, or what?
No, he's going to go.
Will he go the other way?
He'll go the other way. He'll probably kick two rails at this ball. He'll either come in two rails to here or two rails to there. Or he may curve his ball again. I think he's going to play the two-rail shot, though.
Mizerak defeated Martinez. Hobson.
Okay, he's Kidder. Playing. He's
Davenport. Watch. It's a double elimination tournament, remember? Oh, ball in hand.
Well. Reyes has ball in hand.
Down 5-3. The Miz has given Reyes, ball in hand. How's the table set up for him, gentlemen?
Key's going to be going from that 2 to 3.
What he's going to do, he'll play the cue ball all the way over to this side rail. See, he played it different than what I would have played the cue ball all the way to the side rail here and then played two rails down and played the three over here.
What'll he do? Will he cut this down in the corner? What's he gonna do with it?
I think he wanted to fall straight in on that two where he could go straight down table toward the pocket.
Yeah.
He's gonna play it, and he's falling in a little bit of a tough position.
He's gotta really juice his rock.
I mean, he's not gonna have much of a shot at that three, is he?
He's perfect.
Oh boy,
he fell right in the gap.
That was a nice shot.
He fell right in the gap.
Well, that was a small window there.
fallen through the cracks. He really did, didn't he? Four ball in the side, five ball up in the corner. He's got to come back for the six. Nope, going to put the five in there. See, stupid me, I'd have had the five ball in that corner up there and the cue ball in Poughkeepsie. He'll bring it right back down, won't he? Yeah, look at that.
He may be too far down.
Well, the way he can cut the ball, though, it's just...
But that's what he gets to do. He has to hit one very thin here. Mm-hmm.
Is that what you had in mind? That's something? Eight ball on the side, the nine ball in the corner, and he's up 6-3. Reyes leads 6-3 over Steve Mizerak in the semifinal competition. Pro Tour Championship on Prime continues. Reyes now with quite a run, 6-3 over Mizerak. They were deadlocked at three, and Reyes has taken charge of this semifinal event, continues to break the balls beautifully, and gets a lucky break every here and again. But of course, good players, and he is certainly one of the best, make their luck, and he is very capable of taking advantage of it. The only time Mizerak got off the stool to come play, he was hooked by the corner and really couldn't do a shot, and ended up giving the ball in hand to Reyes, and he ran the table.
Now all he's got to do is get straight in on the three and just shoot and stop. One, two, straight in. Boom.
I tell you, he makes that cue ball do everything but talk. Four's just hanging there.
Well, he sure had some beautiful breaks in this match.
Hasn't he?
Yes, he has.
I hate to denigrate the great talent this guy's got, but some of these breaks, I might be able to make two, three of those balls, buddy. I know you two guys that run the table, so it is not surprising that he is. Any problem with the seven and the six? No problem, huh?
No.
Nothing at all.
Just back it up a hair.
Mm-hmm. Is that what you had in mind?
Yeah. Yep.
Now he'll turn. Is he any good left-handed? What do you think? I tell you. Put a blindfold on him. Steve Mizerak, one of the very best, sits and watches. Not much Steve can do. He can't get to the table.
He's playing great, but he just can't win from that chair.
No. It is now 7-3, race to 11. Before you think it's over, though, I would remind you of our semifinal match of a week ago when Davenport, who's the defending champion in this event, was down 9-2 and came back to win it, 11-10, the match you saw last week, and what a great match it was. So if you're a Mizerak fan, have the faith that he can get up off that stool and get back on the table. For a moment there, everybody, if you're a Mizerak fan, was hoping that Reyes had hit it with the end of the cue and missed everything.
Seven balls going. Yep. Three balls going.
Yep.
Well, all he's got to do is bring the cue ball to this area right here. He's got to shoot the one in this pocket. He'll strike this rally and come back to this area. If he does that, this rack is pretty much over.
He seldom makes a mistake, and Buddy Hall acts as though he wrote the script for him. He's diagrammed it perfectly. A little bit far?
A little short.
A little short.
To win a little further there, because he's going to have to, I believe, go three rails on this. Right between the four and the six.
Look at that. Is that some kind of talent? Got the four up there, the five hanging in the corner. six and eight up there. Boy, he spins that cue ball around, doesn't he? Huh?
Yes, he does.
And the six will go, will it go by the eight up there?
Yes.
Plenty of room, huh?
No problem. All he got to do is just bump the side rail, come out, shoot the eight straight in, draw it back a little bit for the nine.
With dispatch. Now the nine ball. Reyes leading 7-3. Looking to take and does an 8-3 advantage over Steve Mizerak in the semifinal competition. The winner goes on to play for the championship. So Efren Reyes with a lead of 8-3 in games played in the race to 11 here in this semifinal competition gets up to come back for the break. And Steve the Miz Mizerak across the way looks on. Not much he can do about it. When given an opportunity, he's played brilliantly, but Reyes just won't let him get to the table.
He must be scared to death of Steve, ain't he? Won't let him get to the table.
He won't.
Wow.
He may get a chance.
It looked like the old slugaroo there. I mean, it just the balls didn't seem to separate very well. And he hooked Steve again. He didn't make one that time.
Yeah, he's going to have to push out again, buddy.
What did Steve say to him? Huh? What did Steve say?
No telling. He may have a shot at the one. If he can hit the one, he may be able to play it down in the corner.
For six racks, and I got to come to this.
Yeah, from shooting 985. Look at that stat.
Is that
985.
That's when the Miz is shooting 90%, but every time he gets up, he thinks they're hooked or has no shot. Look at that, 67 balls to 27. And the mistakes, kicking errors, Mizrak's had two, and Reyes has had one. Few mistakes in this match. The Miz just hasn't had a chance to play. He doesn't want this shot.
I don't blame him. I wouldn't want it either. What are you going to do?
Well,
he's going to shoot straight into the nine, like the cue ball all the way to the end rail.
Push out. Mr. Reyes has the option.
Well, a player of Reyes's ability, that's not a big-time problem, is it? Just a lot of green, isn't it?
Well, it's a hard shot to make. He's got a shot here. Mm-hmm. This is the two ball. Now, he has to be careful. He may bump the two, or he may be able to come up and back down for the two. This is a real hard shot. He might even give this shot up. No, he's going to shoot. He may bump the two a little bit with his cue ball. He may not. But if he plays with a high ball, he's got to play the one and the two, it looks like, in the same pocket.
I think he did give it up.
He's trying to hook him with the four.
He did give it up.
Oh, he ducked. He played safe.
Is that what we pool players call it? We ducked, huh?
Yes, he did.
Has the Miz got a chance? Have we got the Miz up to play some pool here now or what?
Yeah, he's got a bank shot.
He's going to play safe, I think.
He's down 8-3. How can you play safe?
No, Buddy was right. He's banking it.
Beautiful.
Nice shot.
He's got a shot. I believe the three passes the 7-2. He's okay here if he can just get by. He needs to come all the way to the rail with this one.
Why did you think he was going to play safe, Nick? He's got to get up and make some balls, doesn't he? You can't let this guy get ahead of him or it's going to be kitty by the door. Good night, Irene, and everything else.
Well, the angle, I just didn't think he could bank it.
Didn't think he could bank it, huh? But he did it beautifully. No.
He got tougher.
What's he going to do?
He's in trouble right here.
Yeah, he went down too far.
I'd just try to cut it in that right corner.
Try to cut it in this pocket. But the only problem is you have this pocket here is giving you a lot of problems.
Yeah.
It's hard for him to elevate. Right. If he can elevate his cue to hit the rail here, then he has a shot. He's in a tough spot.
He can't bank it right straight back across?
I don't think so.
Well, he looks like he's looking to make it.
He's going to have to miss the side pocket with a cue ball.
I think that's what he's worried about. Can he miss it?
You think that's a dead scratch if he goes to cut it in the end?
Okay, he may be banking it across the corner.
I hope he does that. Oh, no.
Playing safe is what he elected to do. Yeah. And he's trying to get him with the four.
I tell you, he did a pretty good job of it, didn't he?
That's a nice shot there.
Yeah.
Now, one thing you have to be careful here, if he crosses over that three ball, that cue ball is going to be headed right toward the nine, buddy.
Now, he has a shot here. I'd like to show you what it is here, what I think he's going to try to do. He's going to try to go one, two rails behind. He's going to try to kick one, two, into the back of the three ball, which is right here, and knock the five into the nine. He's looking at that shot. He's going to play
it first, friends. You heard it here first. And he may just get it done. He is so good.
Well, he went straight into it. He was trying to get it.
That's right. And I tell you, and I don't know if he didn't leave the Miz with much of a shot here anyway. But that's exactly what he had in mind, didn't he? Well, you know, up 8-3, he's got a little leeway, certainly.
Miz will try to put him behind the four again, don't you think, Tom?
I don't know.
I think that's what he's going to do.
Oh, he got a bad... He got kissed by the five. That's bad. Boy, this table's fast becoming all set up for Reyes.
I thought he might spin up one rail with English, buddy, instead of going two rails.
That's what I thought. I didn't know he was going to try two rails. I thought he'd go one rail up behind the four.
Look at that.
I think the corner pocket's in.
Wow.
That's the Miserec needed that real bad, buddy.
Amen. Yes, he did.
Yeah. Well, he hasn't had many breaks, and now he's got to take advantage of this one. Little chalk on the stick. Chalk your cue. You're looking at serious pool. Reyes cuts that in beautifully, and look at... What'd you say, Nick? The corner pocket got in the way.
Been there for 100 years, hadn't it?
Got in the way in one of my matches, too, this tournament.
Ooh.
He's got to be below it. He didn't get below it.
Ooh, that's not good.
He didn't get below it. He needed to be below the five. He's in a tough spot.
How does he get the cue ball back here for the six? What does he do?
It's very hard to do from where he's at.
Look at that.
Oh, he ran into the eight. It would have been a perfect shot.
It would have been
shot,
an ideal shot.
And he played bad position to the five.
Yeah, and he almost pulled it off with a great shot, but he, as you say, the eight ball caught him. Now, what's he going to do with the six? Will he bank it down here in the corner?
No? I believe he'll just try to thin it and bring the cue ball down two rails behind the seven.
Boy, this is fraught with danger. He's down 8-3. If he just thins that and gets it over near the pocket and that leaves that cue ball in a bad spot, why, Reyes will run the table on him.
Right, exactly. He's going to try to get behind the seven here.
Oh, he knocked her right toward the hole.
Yes, he did.
Yeah, I would have went to the other side of it. Well, he's pretty lucky. He left him upstairs dead straight in.
Yeah. If he wasn't on top of that nine, he'd have an easy shot.
Yeah. Well, he's not exactly straight in. He's got a little bit of an angle, so he's got a little hope. It's by no means a bargain.
You got to be sure he don't foul the nine ball on his follow-through here.
Right.
Oh, the eight's getting in the way. Now he cleared it.
Well, he cut the seven over in the left hand or the right hand corner.
Left hand, I believe.
Left hand. Can he get it by the eight to do that? I guess he can. Huh?
Yeah, he played right there beside the nine.
He might play the nine.
That's the first miss in the match by, I think, either player.
Well, he had one. He had one where he gave a ball in hand to Miserac.
Miz has a bank here. All he's got to do is hit and stick. I mean, I think that's what it looks like.
Gonna have to bank this cross side.
Mm-hmm.
But Miz was hoping to maybe shoot something straight in there.
If I were he, I would have hoped that.
It went too wide.
He played it wide. He didn't have to play it wide.
Well, I don't think Reyes will give him another opportunity in this rank. Nope. Reyes is looking to go up 9-3. Mizerak had some chances. They weren't great chances, but he had an opportunity. Mm-hmm.
Well, last week we saw 1-9-2 come back.
Yeah, he did. Well, Reyes, beautiful position with the cue ball, brings it right down, and the 9 ball in the corner, and he leads 9-3 in the race to 11 as you're watching semifinal competition for the Pro Tour Championship. Reyes leads 9-3 in the race to 11. He has the cue in hand and will be breaking this rack. Mizerak has had trouble getting up to the table. And in the last rack, when he did, he really didn't have much in the way of easy shots, and he kind of complicated his problems by playing some bad position on a couple.
Watch out, 9.
Oh, boy. Mm.
Ball comes slicing across there. You know, he may not have a shot.
In fact, he does have a shot here. Can he play that 3 off the 8 toward the pocket where the 9's at here, buddy?
Right, that's what.
A kiss shot.
Okay, what he'll do is he'll hit this side of the 3, knocking it over this way and sending the cue ball around.
Are you kidding me? How do you make a shot like that?
He got unlucky, he got a kiss. Well, he knew that there was a chance of that anyway because he was running into traffic.
Wow. What can he do with this?
Not much.
He's safe, I think.
Well,
combination.
It's not much. Yeah, the 4 and the 6, it's not much, but the Miz, what am I, the combination guy all of a sudden?
Yeah.
Did you see that, Nick? He said, combination, patted me on the back, said, all right, Cal, you
better get on the ball here, Tom. This is your shot.
You go do this one, Tom, combination. See if the Miz can pull it off. Oh, he's going for the 9.
Yeah.
Oh!
He might have left him a billiard. I think he left a billiard at it.
Can he get just enough of that and spin that cue ball into the 9?
I think he can.
Oh, boy. Now, that is bad luck.
I think he can hit just the right side of the 4, draw the cue ball right into the 9. Maybe he can't hit enough of it. Maybe he can't hit enough of it. No.
Oh,
he
didn't.
A bad hit.
Yeah. It'll be a ball in hand. For the Miz.
I can make this one. Mizerak has ball.
Boy, the Miz is going after this like a hound dog goes after a bone. Talking his way into this one. Yeah. All right. The Miz gets back. He is without a doubt one of Poole's all-time great players and colorful personalities. Take a look here. As you watch again. What, do you say something like even Kelly could make this one? He probably did. And I don't know that I could have. At any rate, it is now 9-4. Reyes in one of his infrequent errors. I thought for a minute he was going to pull it off, bust it right off, and just throw that cue ball right into the 9. 9-4. Now let's see if Steve the Miz can make a big-time comeback here in this semifinal match. Winner goes on to play for the championship against the defending champion, Davenport. He got a ball.
Did
he get the 5 out of the way?
He got a good shot.
All right, he's got a shot at the 1. He's got the 2 over on the left side. Is that a problem? Missed the 2 ball here?
Right.
Isn't that it? Yeah.
Okay, he'll play the 1 ball right in here, play the cue ball. I believe, out to this area right here, because the two will go in this pocket. Mm-hmm.
And the three is right in the middle of the table there. One, and just like you said, beautifully done. Nice position for the two.
You want it to be straight in. He's not quite straight. He may have to play the two and the three in the opposite. He may have to play the three in this side instead of the other side. He may have to just follow it one rail up. Oh.
Tried to kick it out of the wind.
Right, he's in trouble.
Boy.
I think he can hit it. He may be able to slice it in.
Well, he can cut the three in the side, yeah. I think, but he's going to be running, and I don't know if he can avoid that eight ball or not. And the position is real tricky.
If he can hit it, he can cut it in.
He may try to hit the eight.
Beautiful. Oh, I thought he made it.
Look out.
Oh.
They overcut it.
Did he?
He overcut it, yeah.
Yeah, overcut it.
Yeah. Three balls all set. Here in Reyes again. He leads 9-4. Four ball. Easy. Five.
Yeah, just shoot and stop.
Mm-hmm. Five up the other side. He'll stop. Put the seven right back in the side. Eight. Nine. Looks like my kind of table now.
Mm-hmm. You don't want to get overconfident here. He needs to back over to the other side of the table so he can have an angle.
Yeah, but he'll do that easily, won't he? Look at that.
He's got an angle.
Will he play it off the rail and take it back up there for the nine ball back down here?
Right, absolutely. Yeah. Exactly. He'll play it one rail across.
Yeah, he is so good with that cue ball. Boy, you can't give him a break. He just takes it away from you. So Reyes now, 10-4, leads Steve the Miz Mizerak in the semifinal competition. The Miz is down 10-4, and Reyes will go to the rack with the break and a chance to win this semifinal event. We'll be back to see how it turns out. Reyes is back now, ready for the break, needs one more game, one more rack to move to the championship. He's up 10-4. Amazing. Made the nine ball on the break, and that finishes that in somewhat regal fashion. Mizerak is up to congratulate him, and Reyes certainly was on top of his game here in the semifinal competition, as Reyes now will move on and challenge for the championship against Kim Davenport next week. And there's the nine ball as it falls in on the break. I believe the first time the nine ball was made on the break in this match, gentlemen. And of course, Reyes, who does it with a bit of flamboyance, picked that last game. He was up 10-4 and made the nine ball on the break to win it 11-4. We'll be back with a final comment. It's going to be EFREN Reyes moving into the finals against Davenport. He's the defending champion. We're here with all of the contestants and all the participants, and we had a fine semifinal match. For Steve Mizerak, it ended too soon. This is some kind of a player, this guy, Reyes.
Yes, he is. He played magically.
He did indeed. He's known as the magician, of course. Rolando, would you congratulate EFREN for us and tell him how much we enjoyed watching him play?
Nagpapasalamat daw sila na enjoy sila nanonood sa mga laro mo ngayon.
Kaya kung ginagawa ko yung maganda tiro para masiyahan sila.
Yeah, that's what he said. He try all his best to make his game to be real entertainment for all the audiences.
And of course, the videotape of this is being shown in his native Philippines. I was impressed not only with his skill at playing pool, because we've seen him before and he's magnificent at it, but he had the best of the breaks. I mean, he made 2-3 balls every time he broke the rack.
Oh, ina nga daw yung mga break mo yon, lahat ng mga break mo puro pasok ng pasok.
Because I learn for everybody, the player. They break good. That's what I learned for them.
What he said was everybody plays good, so he's got to have a good break. Knock a couple in. In fact, he kind of finished off this semifinal match by making the nine ball, Nick Varner, on the break, didn't he? What a way to end it all.
Yeah, it was really, the break was kind of the dominating factor in the match. He just had marvelous breaks all the way through. Steve started off, he just played marvelous, and he's playing great and stuff, but Ephraim just took it right away from him with the break. He just broke marvelous.
Buddy, we all agreed that the Miz was back on top of his game and in good form, and just didn't get a chance to play, though. I mean, you can't make balls if you're sitting over there in that chair, and Reyes wouldn't let him get to the table.
You're exactly right about that. The time when he did come to the table, he came with no shot. One time he came to the table, he was...
I love that. What did you think of when you were hooked up here around the corner, huh?
I said, oh, no.
I'll tell you something else you said, too. I think when you made that combination and made the nine ball, you said...
Kelly could make that.
Let me read some of these statistics. 11-4. Balls pocketed, 82 for Reyes. Let me tell you, the Miz was way over 90% early on in this match and never really got to play. We mentioned the fact that a senior tour is in the offing, and you're very much involved with it.
Yes, I'm organizing a senior tour for anybody over 50 years of age. I hate to say this, but Buddy Hall will be a part of that senior tour.
The Rifleman, he's been chalking his cue.
And a couple other great players, Mike LeBron, a few other players, and hopefully when you see it in your magazine or in your paper or something, you'll come out and watch, or you'll call me, because there'll be a number there for you to get in touch with me if you want to play. Anybody can play who's 50, just call me, put your money up, and belly up to the bar.
That's wonderful. I was going to bring up that belly up. Incidentally, how is your health and how's your back? Your fans want to know.
Very good. I'm fine health, and except I have a sore throat this week and a little back pain. I haven't played this much in a long time.
That's right. And it is good to see you back. I know you've been very active in a lot of things, not the least of which is putting the senior tour together. But I think we said it on the telecast, what a treat it was and a pleasure to see you back in action. And I hope that you're back competing on a regular basis and playing in these title matches for many years to come.
I'll see you in January at Riviera Country Club. Right. Get your sticks out, and I'm ready to play you some golf.
I tell you, I haven't got a chance against the Miz, whether it's golf or pool. Let me get back to Rolando and Efren Reyes. Has he played Davenport? He's going to have to go against him in the championship. Has he played him in this tournament this week?
I don't think so. He didn't play Kim Davenport in this week.
Uh-huh. Has he played Davenport before?
Oh, yeah, he played Davenport before.
That last year ago, not this year.
Uh-huh. Good player, isn't he?
Yeah, he's a good player, though.
The semifinal match he had with Archer, Efren, was something else again. It was magnificent. Tough, wasn't it?
Yeah, I think it's magnificent because before he's behind by like 5-6 games.
Yes, he was. In fact, he was down 9-2 and 10-5. Mm-hmm. And Archer sat there very much like the Miz did and couldn't do much about it. And here he wins it 11-10. Efren, you're a magnificent champion. They say you must be among the best in the world, if not the best in the world. How big is pool in the Philippines? We understand it's very big, Rolando.
Yeah, pool is big back home, and not only that, probably it's one of the top sport in our country right now.
Okay. All right, gentlemen, we've enjoyed watching you play. We wish you the very best in the championship match, Efren, and I know it's going to be a dandy. Nick, our thanks to you, hometown boy here in Owensboro. You're doing such a fine job. Miz, you look great. What a pleasure.
Maybe you'll practice and playing the senior tour.
It could take a lot of practice, Steve. And, Buddy, thank you so much for your kind comments and your observations. And, of course, we've got the big championship match coming up. And we'll be back to talk about the match between Reyes and Davenport for the title in just a bit. Stay tuned. And so next week it's going to be the championship for the Pro Tour, and that'll be Kim Davenport, who's the defending champion, against Efren Reyes. I'm joined again by Nick Varner and by Buddy Hall, who talked a little bit about these two men and this championship match coming up. I don't know if anybody, when you give them a chance, is as good as Efren Reyes. This guy just seems to be phenomenal when given an opportunity to make balls.
Efren is one of the, maybe the best player I've ever seen. He is one of the top three of the best players I've ever seen. There's nothing you can say about the guy that he kicks better than anybody in America. He shoots as straight as anybody in America. He breaks the ball just about as well as anybody.
Boy, does he break the balls, I guess. In fact, that last break he had and the nine ball goes in, what a dramatic way to end it. He seems to have every move, every deft touch. He's got, he's a magician with the cue ball, and he can slice and cut that object ball beautifully. He's amazing. You ever seen anybody as good as he is?
Well, right now, he's really on a roll. Starting with last year's U.S. Open, he's been awful hard to beat. He's definitely been the man to beat on our Pro Tour. And we'll see in this next match if Kim's going to be able to slow him down.
Is Reyes the best Filipino player?
Yes.
Better than Bustamante and the others over there?
Yes, he's the number one ranked player in the Philippine Islands.
And I guess he's the number one ranked player in the world. Yet he can be beaten because we saw Pierce beat him in the U.S. Open for nine-ball championship.
Exactly. Reed did beat him. Reed played great. Last year, a little something that we might mention here. Last year, EFREN was on the loser side, and Kim met EFREN and did beat EFREN that match to advance to the finals to eventually win the tournament. I'm not saying that'll happen again, yes, but sir. EFREN can be beat. You have to play a solid game. You have to play mistake-proof. You can't make any errors, and you have to make everything you shoot at in order to beat him.
And, of course, we saw Davenport, who has got a great deal of mental toughness about him, come from 9-2 down and 10-5 down to win his match 11-10. I didn't think he had a chance to win that match against Archer, yet he did. So he's very tough.
Oh, he's real tough, and I think what it's going to boil down to in the match, both are really great players. I think it's going to boil down to who's able to break the balls the best and get the most opportunities to win after the first shot.
I guess what I was trying to say was no matter what happens to Davenport, don't count him out because he is a very tough guy inside.
Can't count him out. He just ran six wrecks and out on Johnny.
And, of course, Reyes, there aren't many better that play this game, and it is a title match that we are all looking forward to seeing.
Kim Davenport, defending champion, hopes to make it two in a row. And who's to say this isn't his special tournament? He was a dramatic comeback winner over Johnny Archer in the semis and advances to the title match tonight. And he'll need all the magic and skill he can muster as he faces perhaps the best pool player in the world, EFREN Reyes of the Philippines. He one-sided the legendary Steve Mizerak to move to this title showdown. Tonight, from Owensboro, Kentucky, the finals of the Pro Tour Championship.
And thank you. A very special welcome from Owensboro, Kentucky. The fans love their pool down here. And time for some serious pool. We've got the Pro Tour Championship. I'm Tom Kelly with two of the legends of the game, Buddy Hall, the Rifleman right here, and, of course, homegrown Nick Varner, Owensboro's favorite son. You can applaud if you'd like for Nick. He's a great host. Isn't it great to have this tournament in your hometown, Nick? It might make you proud.
It's really been the thrill of a lifetime to have the Pro Tour Championship right in my backyard.
I do know you'd have liked it a lot better if you'd been playing this title match tonight. But, hey, maybe one of these days, huh? Wouldn't that be great?
Maybe I could talk Kim and Ephraim, one of them, in stepping out tonight.
Oh, no. These two tough guys want to play it right down to the wire. And what a great title match we've got tonight. Davenport came from way back. Nobody gave him a chance. He's the defending champ, and he beat Archer. What a thrilling semifinal that was.
It was an unbelievable finals. Like I said, you know, we don't have very many people that can come back from 9-2. At least they're not running in herds, like we said. But anyway, he was down 9-2, then 10-5. Ran six racks and out, I think.
Yes, he did, and won 11-10. EFREN Reyes, of course, is considered by many to be the best pool player in the world. He one-sided Steve Mizerak routinely 11-4, and in fact, he finished it off with the break and made the nine ball, kind of the cap to the whole thing. He's going to be tough to beat tonight.
He sure is. He's the number one ranked player right now in the Pro Billiard Tour. And if you watch that last match last week with Steve Mizerak and EFREN Reyes, he certainly proved it in that match.
Of course, Davenport said he's done everything this week that he did a year ago. And that means he's going to win it again and retain the championship. We'll find out what kind of a prophet he is and just how good a pool player, too. The Pro Tour Championship, the final, coming your way. Stay tuned.
So the Pro Tour Championship, the finals, comes down to EFREN Reyes against Kim Davenport, the defending champion. First man to 11. And now perhaps the most important shot either man will make tonight, and that is the lag to see who gets the opportunity for the first break. The man who puts the cue ball closest to that rail right there, and it's going to be Reyes, and he'll get to start first. And the way Reyes performed,
in the semifinals with the break. Boy, that's a big edge for him. Let's check the rules that govern play here. They lagged for the break, as you saw. The balls are shot in numerical order. Ball in hand on all fouls. Push-out option after the break. When that occurs, we'll explain it to you. Three consecutive fouls is the loss of the rack. The player who pockets the nine ball wins the rack, even if it's on the break. And, of course, it's a race to 11. Whoever wins 11 games first wins the Pro Tour Championship. Get back, gentlemen, Nick and Buddy, that breaking ability that Reyes showed us in the semifinals against the Miz. He was fantastic breaking that.
He was. He was absolutely fantastic. He made a ball or two balls, even three balls a couple times. Always had his cue ball out in the middle of the table.
And capped it off when he made the nine ball on the break, and that wrapped up everything. And he beat the Miz 11-4, and here he is now. Now we'll see if he continues the magic in that regard. Yeah, he's made one already. And he's got, well, I think he's probably got the cue ball and the one ball in pretty good shape again, hasn't he?
Well, the key here is going to be he's got a good shot on the one, but the problem is how to get the cue ball lined up for position on the two. See, when he cuts the one in that corner pocket, the cue ball is going to go to the right up the table, so he's got to try to figure out how to get it back down table.
I tell you,
and he's going to look like use reverse and try to go two rails off the right side.
They call him the magician.
Question is it hard enough?
No, I don't think so. It's going to leave him a little more difficult shot than he had imagined. But he, we've seen him do some unbelievably magical things. What's he going to do, cut this two ball back, or is he playing safe or what?
Safety.
Safety.
Going to try to snooker him with that green six ball there.
And he
did exactly what he's trying to do.
Looks like he did it, Nick, didn't he? Huh?
Sure did.
So here's Kim Davenport, the defending champion.
He's going to try to curve around the six, hit the back rail, knock the two up table, and play safe.
He did that exactly. Yeah. Now if he gets a favorable bounce and can hide it, well, he needed a little longer bounce off that side rail, and he might have had that thing hidden.
That was still a good shot from Aries. Mm-hmm. He made a great shot there. At least after him, he has to make a good shot to start out here.
He's got a shot. He's just, the way he has to come off, he has to be careful of the side pocket. The way he has to come off of the two.
Makes it.
Oh, he come close, buddy.
He did. Yes, he did.
He come close to that side, but he made a nice shot.
Yes, he did. Yeah. And he had a lot of green between cue ball and the two ball. He's a masterful player.
Yeah, he's got to bring the cue ball all the way back for the ball right by the cue ball, the five ball.
Watch out.
Six ball slowed him down, but it didn't bother him enough. He'll have the five ball in the corner up there on the right side. And then what will he do about the six? Where will he put that thing?
He'll probably draw underneath of it.
Well, he's going to take it all the way back down the corner, isn't he? Huh? Apparently. And put some follow on it for the seven? Huh? Not much, though, huh?
Basically, he's just going to go head to the right and play the seven in the same pocket.
Masterful handling of the cue ball and the stick, working his way beautifully through this rack. Now the eight ball and the nine, and it appears that he's going to open up with a 1-0 lead. And that's it. The first rack goes to EFREN REYES of the Philippines. He's the current eight ball champion. He's been in most every championship event this past year. He's had a magnificent run on the Pro Tour, the Billiards Tour, and here he is now leading 1-0. It's Prime bringing you coverage of the Pro Tour Championship. We're in Owensboro, Kentucky. Beautiful city right on the banks of the Ohio River. Crowds turned out.
It's what I call home, Tom.
Yeah, it is nice, isn't it? Yeah, it's comforting. Very nice. All right, here's Reyes. Boy, I don't know. I don't think you can let him stand there and break these balls all night and expect to beat him. But
no, you can't.
Uh-uh.
Needs one. Didn't get one. Is he going to come up empty?
Yeah, I believe he came up empty. And he's left.
Except that one ball, huh?
Yeah, he's left Kim a really good shot.
Yeah. Now we'll see about Davenport. Young man from Modesto, California. What great mental toughness. He showed us down 9-2 and 10-4 and 10-5. And he came back to beat Archer in that thrilling semifinal event. And, of course, Archer must feel as though he's snake bit and jinxed. Every time he's had a magnificent year, he just can't win the big one.
Right. He is pretty fairly simple out here.
Well, he's got to be a little careful.
Two balls down in this end of the table.
He's got to get by that ball.
Come on, come on, come on. Well, he did. Just did.
I'll tell you what's a little tricky on this 2-3-4.
Well, he's got to play the 2 and the 3 in the same pocket.
Right.
But he needs an angle to get back to the 4, see?
Yeah, he needs to cross that line and get back toward the middle of the table.
Well, he could have used a little bit better bump off that 5, couldn't he?
Well,
where's he going to put the 3 ball?
Must have been playing it for the side, I guess.
That's not an easy shot to cut that in the side, is it?
No, I don't think he was playing it for the side. I think he just overcut the 2 a little bit.
Could have been.
Came up short.
Yeah.
Because the 3 doesn't look like it fits in the side.
He can't get it by the 6 ball. How about banking it then, right? Straight across and back.
That might be the shot.
That might be the shot considering where the 4's at.
He's going to cut it. He's not going to bank it.
Oh,
beautiful, beautiful. Needs to bounce off the 5. All right. That's a beautiful shot.
Actually, that worked out pretty good because now when he cuts the 4 in that left upper corner pocket, he'll come around 2 rails. I think he can avoid the 8 and fall for that 5 right in the side.
Okay. He can get the 5 in one side and the 6 in the other.
Like so to play position on the 5. He just come 2 rails out of the corner.
Oh. And he has left this table wide open for Reyes, and that is a no-no. Oh, boy. Reyes will run this table without a blink of an eye. He was probably playing too much position and got over, just overplayed the shot. Reyes will cut that in the corner, rattles it in. Come back, he'll put the 5 down in the other corner, lower right-hand corner as you watch from above, and he'll have the 6 back across on the other side. And he'll be, he'll bring it back just a little bit so he'll be right in line for that 7, I imagine, huh?
Yeah, straight in is a perfect place for the 7. All he wants to do when he shoots the 7 is just shoot and stop.
Yeah, takes it right off the rail, stop it, put the 8 up in the corner. He's going to be up 2 zip. Is the 9 ball is against the rail?
Right, it's a real soft shot here. He just come 1 rail down. Maybe use this side rail over here. No, he used the end rail instead.
Mm-hmm. Off the rail and set up perfectly to put the 9 ball in the corner and take a 2-0 lead. Well, without belaboring the point, it is indeed the case in point. Don't give that man right there an opportunity to get that pool cue going on the table because he will just bury you if given the chance. Reyes leads 2-0 over Davenport. We'll be back with more in a moment. Times coverage of the Pro Tour Championship. This is Reyes, EFREN Reyes of the Philippines. Number one player, certainly in history, conceivably in the world. He's out in front 2-0. And he will... I don't know what he can do with that 1 ball. That looks like, I don't think he can cut it back. He's either going to have to, listen.
I believe he can play it down the corner.
Do you think that's a scratch, isn't it? As you watch Kim Davenport look on, Kim's got to get back in this game. He can't let Reyes get that far ahead, down 2-0. Isn't that a scratch if he?
No.
Huh?
Now he'll play it down the corner. He'll just go straight to this rail and just a little bit. He'll come about to there.
But he didn't, and he did make it. Isn't that something? What a fortunate little bounce, and he's all set now for the 2 in the other corner.
The 3's the one that's really the problem. The 3, the ball is down by the 9. In fact, he may even play for the combination here. He may play for the combination on the 9.
Take the 9 ball. In fact, he's eyeballing it while he
contemplates what he's going to do with the two ball, where he's going to put the cue ball. He'll have to bring it all the way back down to the corner.
Right.
Didn't do it.
He's coming right back where he was at. I don't know if he got far enough or not there.
I don't either. Take a look at it from up above. Between he and that
three.
Ball.
This eight ball right here may have him blocked. He may not have a path to the three. He may be curving it a little bit.
Yeah, he is curving it.
Missed it.
Oh, he missed it.
Wow. I tell you,
Davenport has ball in hand.
That is one of the few times you will see Reyes make a mistake like that.
I believe Cam will shoot the combination.
I don't blame him. He's down 2-0. And this looks like an ideal chance to get right back into this contest and be down 2-1 and have the cue ball ready for the break.
This is a real easy combination. He won't have much problem with this, I don't think.
Get his ducks lined up in a row.
That's right.
How about that? All of a sudden, it's 2-1. Reyes making an infrequent mistake, and it opens the door, and Davenport rushes right through it to get into this match. It's 2-1 after three racks. Remember, the first 1-11 will claim the championship, and Davenport's the defending champ. And now we'll see about him as you watch it again, and as Buddy Hall says, a rather simple little combination there.
They're always a lot easier if you can just take your and just lay your ball down.
That's
where
right.
You want to.
And from up here, they really get a lot easier.
Hard to miss from here.
Huh? Really. I've been so good from up here making those shots. 2 and 3 cushions.
Yeah, Tom, you were at 3 racks a while ago.
I did indeed. Just they were throwing babies out of the balcony. They didn't know I could do that. Now we'll see about Davenport in this break.
Well, he's breaking them hard. You know, that could be the difference in this whole match. The seven's trying to play havoc with him.
Yep.
If he can't play that three in his corner, he may have big problems with that three, huh?
Or he may have another shot, too.
Well, what can he do with it? Bring that cue ball back to after he makes the one. What's he going to do to?
Well, he can pull the cue ball all the way down and maybe play the combination in the side.
Oh, I see.
Or he may be able to go all the way down underneath it and play the three up here in the other in the same pocket he's playing the one. Or he may be able to hit it.
And get a nice,
nice shot.
Very nice. Beautiful.
Nice shot.
Beautiful shot. Yeah, took that eight ball right out of there, took it out of play, and now he's still got enough room to maneuver that cue ball and the three ball and put it in the pocket. That's Scott Smith, the referee, checking, make sure that Kim Davenport doesn't touch or move another ball while playing the shot. That would be a foul. Very nice. Looked for a moment like he almost overplayed that, but he got it in there, drilled it in.
The only problem I see here may be the seven ball. 6-7.
Davenport trying to run the table to even this at 2 racks apiece in the race to 11. Used a little body English in addition to everything else on that, didn't he?
Yeah, that's a common English that all pool players use. We have a lot of different methods of some people jump. You know, when they shoot, they jump on the ball, and others, when they shoot, they squat.
Yeah. And they all come up later and say, boy, you know, I don't know why my back hurts so much.
Well, he's got a real speed control shot here. He's got to hit this good. He's going to hit two rails, hit short of the side, and try to float down between that 8 and 9.
He hit it great.
Oh,
he's right
nice.
There.
Very
and
nice.
And that just requires marvelous speed control.
Beautiful shot. He's trying to take advantage and move to a 2-2 tie. Taking his time.
I would follow this ball. I wouldn't draw it. I would follow it. He's thinking about drawing it.
There's Kim's wife, Aida, looking on.
Mm-hmm.
Now he's following it.
Mm-hmm. If she worked her way through about four sets of fingernails in that match with Archer. Beautiful. Now Davenport with the nine ball to tie this at two. Got ourselves a real match. That's nice. 2-2. Well, Reyes may be the best player in the world, but this kid Davenport is one tough guy inside. This promises to be a great match. You stay tuned. We're tied at two. We're tied at three games apiece, and now EFREN Reyes, young man from the Philippines, with the break. He gets after it, too. He did a masterful job in this department against Steve Mizerak. Got kissed away.
Oh, well, they're coming up dry tonight.
All of a sudden. In fact, it was it's weird to think about that because Reyes, in that semifinal match with the Miz, was making two and sometimes three balls with a break.
Yeah. So I think he can play this ball in here. He may be able to bring the cue ball this direction. He'll have to force a little bit. If not, he'll have to bring it straight back. But he's got a good shot either way.
One ball in the corner, brings it back now for the two ball, put that in the side. Then the three ball back up in the corner.
The four ball lays over against the side rail, or right there in front of the side pocket. He needs an inside angle, really, to be accurate with it, but he will settle for just pulling it back and then hitting the side rail and coming across.
If he could, after he makes the two, then the three, if he could bring that cue ball back almost to where it is now, between the eight and the six, huh?
Well, that would be okay. He really needs to play, considering where the five is at, he needs to be able to play the four down in the corner.
Oh, really? I see. All right. Okay.
He needs to be straight in on the four.
No, he's going to take it inside. Well, that's what you're talking about. You meant straight on in there, huh?
Well, I meant straight down
the corner.
Down
the corner. I thought you did it first. Yeah, but if he puts that in right there and stops it right there, he's still got a very good shot at the five, does he not, right down?
Right, but I don't think he can do that. I think he's going to have to play the five up there where the nine's at.
Mm.
Unless it's...
I don't think it goes up there, but...
He may can reverse his cue ball.
Not the way the six is. The six is.
Yeah, he's killing it.
That was a nice shot. That was a dangerous shot.
Oof.
I don't think he had a choice. I don't think the five went in another pocket.
Is that right?
Unless he wanted to bump the five.
Well, he's got it lined up now.
Oh, yeah, he likes this.
Yeah. And then the six right back up where, either in the side or back up where the nine ball is. Seven and eight. And the six, will he put it in the side pocket?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I believe he will. Just pull the cue ball over across the top of the eight. Maybe even under the eight if he can draw it. Now he's going all the way up and back.
Mm-hmm.
That's the way to do it.
And the seven down here in the corner, and then the eight and the nine.
See where the cue ball's at right now? That's where he'd love to have it on the next shot.
Amen. Amen. Well, maybe Reyes would let him skip the seven and put the eight in there now. You guys are a friendly bunch in this world of the pro billiard player.
We're not quite that friendly.
I see.
No.
I see.
Usually all the friendship ends with a lag.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, good luck. Good luck to you. Yeah. I got your good luck right here. Yeah. Eight ball. And the nine.
Nice shot.
Up in the corner. Looking to take a 4-3 lead in games. And he's done that. Kim Davenport, very nice. He's really playing smooth and efficient. He's in against the best player in the world, but he shows no fear of Reyes. He has more than matched him shot for shot. As we go to the eighth game, Davenport leads 4-3. Defending champion out of Modesto. Now, I know that Owensboro is beautiful country. Kentucky's a great state. But do you mean to tell me he's going to leave California and come live down here? Hmm? Do you mean to tell me
he
that?
He wins this tournament tonight, he's liable to.
He told me he was looking for a place to move.
Well, if he does it back-to-back, maybe he ought to retire the tournament and call it the Kim Davenport.
Kim Davenport Open.
Mm-hmm. That's right. five ball just.
Isn't that amazing how much different that break's working tonight?
He didn't make one either.
Six. No, he didn't. He came up empty. And now the one ball is set up, and Reyes will probably run the table now.
Okay, if he can miss this six, if he can come to here and back out for the two, then he'll be all right.
Well, he hit
that
the
was
six.
The problem. See, he's dead.
He couldn't get away from the six, and now he's snookered behind the three.
Dead in the water.
Now you know where the two guys with me, Buddy Hall and Nick Varner, are such great pool players and experts. I would never have thought the six ball was a factor in that. Now it's got him. He made the two ball, or he made the one ball, and he's got himself trapped. Well, not really trapped. He can hit the ball, but he can't make it, can he?
No, he can't hit it unless he hits a rail first.
Yeah. And then, of course, you don't know whether
unless
he can
he curve it.
He's going to go over to that rail and come back and try to knock it up the table and end up behind this 3-7. Or no, he come all the way across and may snooker him with the 5.
I tell you.
Or 4.
What a great shot. What a great shot.
That was a great shot.
Mm.
Yeah, that was a nice defensive kick there. But I think Kim may have a shot at cutting the two in.
He did it. If he gets it.
Oh, he overhit it. He may be all right, though. He's all right.
Yes. Came away pretty good. Where can he put, the three down here in the corner?
Right. He played it down the corner and just play the cue ball out in the middle of the table, I believe. Mm-hmm. He may have too stiff an angle for that. If so, he may end up playing the 4 in the side. It just depends on the angle that he has off the 3. Yep, he's elevating.
What about the 9 ball? Could he make the 9 ball? No.
No.
Huh? Combination?
No, he wouldn't.
You don't even think of things like that, huh?
Okay, he's going to have to try to come out like this.
I see.
I would think. That'd be a shot, trying to play the 4 in the upper corner.
Boy, a lot of cue action on that, wasn't there?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yes, it was.
And hopes and prayers and what have you going along with it.
See, I don't know if the 5 even goes by the 9, but he's got an angle where he can just come below the 5 now. He can play the 5 up in the same pocket he shoots the 4 in.
Mm-hmm.
I wouldn't play for the combination. That's the last thing in the world I would do. I don't like shooting combinations.
Well, now he will try the combination now. Trust me on this. Because he can't get the 5 ball past it, can he?
You're a combination man,
Tom. He cannot get the 5 ball past that thing, Nick Varner, and you know it, and he's going to try that 9. And I tell you, I'd have to try it if I were he.
Well, he's got a lot of confidence in combinations. He beat Johnny Archer with a combination last week.
I just think, look at that.
Great shot.
5-3, and Davenport has no backup in him. I'm telling you, he had a great chance to do it, and he did it. It might not have been the easiest combination, but I thought it was an obvious one. And he puts it in. Watch it again. And the 9 ball is in the pocket. He wins the rack, and he's up 5-3 in defense of his title. We'll be back. So Davenport is up 5-3, and he will have the break here. He's the defending champion in the Pro Tour Championship. He's going to the other side now, guys. How come?
I don't blame him. He's came up dry every time he broke him from over there. He's just going over there to see if one might fall from that side.
You mean to tell me there's a little superstition and what have you in games like
well,
this?
Well, sometimes,
huh?
Sometimes the balls will break from one side better than they will the other.
He's not hitting that cue ball.
Scratched.
That cue ball's going way up in the air.
Ball in hand anywhere on the table.
After it hits a 1, it's
mm-hmm.
jumping.
Mm-hmm. Well, where is he hitting it to get that effect off it, Nick? Is he hitting it too low that it pops it up or what?
Too high, I think.
Too high, yeah. And it causes it to, when it hits the rack, it just pops in the air, is that what we're saying?
Yeah, and I honestly think he's hitting them too hard.
Trying to do too much with them.
Yeah, that adrenaline may be too strong.
Well, Reyes now, given an opportunity to get back into it, he trails 5-3 in the race to 11. I just think Reyes is so good that you give him a chance to even take that cue in his hand, get up off that chair, you're courting danger.
He is that good a player. You've got to keep him away from the table.
Yep. Yep. I think in watching him play over the weeks and on the tour this year, we've seen him probably, I don't know, maybe I've seen him make five bad mistakes in all of the matches, and so far he's been able to overcome almost all of them. Magnificent position player, and he does wonderful things with the cue ball. He's got this all set, the five in the corner, six, seven, eight, right in the middle of the table.
Well, I know his sponsor's got to be pretty happy this year, AMF Poyot and Jose Poyot in the Philippines, and I'm sure they're wired to this match tonight. Mm-hmm. And I'd like to say on behalf of the Pro Billiards Tour, he's been a real strong sponsor and supporter of the Pro Billiards Tour. I'd like to say hello and wish him a...
all the best, huh?
All the best. And I understand they're working right now on Don Mackey, the commissioner's working on negotiations to take the Pro Billiards Tour to the Philippines next year in 96.
I would think that would be a big box office item. Well done by Reyes. I mean, the popularity of billiards in the Far East, in the Orient, and certainly in the Philippine Islands in particular, where they've got a magnificent collection of players. I mean, Reyes is just one of several, but I think admittedly the best over there. And of course, he gives every indication whenever you watch him play that he might just be the best player, period. Reyes got off quickly, and Davenport had to regroup and come back and took a lead of 5-3, and now it's 5-4, and Reyes now, he swung to the other side for the break. Well, they're looking for a little magic from the cue ball here, trying to find a way to jar him loose. What do you make?
One,
yeah, he
two.
Made the one ball, too.
And he's got good position on the two.
See, he let up on it a little bit and hit a little off to the left-hand side of the one.
He has a shot right
here. This is the three ball right here. He has to figure out a way to get all the way down table.
And he didn't do it.
No, I think he came up short.
He did not do it. And in fact, he has snookered himself. He's going to have to go off a rail. Look at him. He's really upset with that shot.
Well, I think he should have played it two rails. He should have played the ball two rails around.
I know something from the look on his face. I think he thinks you're right and that he wishes he could have done it again. He's, the only way he can hit this thing, Dick, is come off the rail, isn't it?
Yeah, he's got to kick it off this rail to the left and try to make contact with the threes. He's maybe left Kim a shot here.
Yes, he has. And the four ball is up at that end, am I correct? Is that it up there? Yep. Then he's got to get back for the five. If he gets that three and then gets the four, comes back for the five and the six, why, he's in pretty good shape to run this rank.
Can Kim draw over and catch that right rail and stay down for the four, or does he have to run into the four here?
No, he can draw all the way over to the side rail and back out. I believe he can play the three in here, draw his cue ball to the side rail and back out. Worst comes to worst, he can just draw his ball over here. He has to hit the ball too soft to do that. I believe he'll go ahead and hit it. I believe he'll draw it one rail out.
Very deliberate in this
shot. Seems like he's trying to make up his mind.
Yeah, I think, Nick, you've hit it right on the head. He's a little indecisive. I wonder if he selected the right play.
Yep, he played it soft.
Yeah, got away a beautiful shot.
That's a tough shot there.
Yep.
He made a great shot. Great position on the four ball.
He must have had to cut it too much to draw it over there.
Well, how's he going to get down now for the five? Is that kind of routine, or is it not that easy?
Right, it's not an easy shot at all. He's got a situation here that's pretty much a problem. He's going to have to go down and play the combination on the... He's either going to have to drop all the way below the five or play the combination on the nine in the corner, in the side pocket.
Well, now you're talking my kind of pool, boys. We're back to that combination on the nine ball. Mm-hmm. All right, Kim, make this baby, and then we'll get to work on that combination.
I like playing the two rails all the way to the end rail and playing the five up in the other corner.
See how you are? And I thought you were the adventuresome type, buddy. Oh,
he missed that.
Oh, maybe you can get a break.
He was trying to play position for the same pocket, wasn't he, buddy?
Yeah. Yes, he was.
So...
The five ball is really a problem here.
You know what I like here, buddy?
Rail first?
I like playing... No, I like just playing the four, bouncing off and banking that ball and leaving the cue ball behind the eight and nine and banking that next shot.
He played rail first.
He's going to make it.
Oh!
and he snookered himself behind the nine. You know, he almost pulled off an unbelievable shot, didn't he?
Well, he left the four in. He was playing rail first and playing the four down the corner. It banked.
I see.
This rail
you
and
mean
banked
he got away with something.
Right.
And but what
see,
did he get away
with? See,
watch
the way the ball goes.
Yeah. 5-4, Davenport leads. This is Reyes now.
He's playing the nine, probably. No, he's ducking.
Oh.
He's lucky.
Oh,
he got lucky there.
Mm.
He got lucky there.
When you get down to where there's four balls on the table and the cue ball, and you can't afford to make a mistake here.
You're
so
right.
what's Kim going to do? The only way he can hit that five is come off a rail and hit it, and then what does he do?
Well, he may be able to hit the edge of it.
Well, you think he can?
Yeah, if he can hit the edge of it, he's just going to bring the cue ball back over to this side of the table.
Well, if he can hit the edge, he can make it, can't he?
No.
No. All right.
Is he going to go between the six and the nine?
Right. Right, I think that's what he's going to try to do. Bank it one rail right up by the diamond there.
Yeah, he's playing safe here. No, he didn't. He did something different.
Well, he laid it right in there, between the six and the eight.
Can Efren make this rail first, or does he have to go to the right rail?
I believe he might can play it rail first.
Can't reach it, though, can he, to put that little curve on it he needs, maybe? Well, he can shoot. We'll see if he shoots this one opposite-handed, buddy.
No, he's not going to shoot that one opposite-handed. Yes, he is going to shoot
that one. You ready for that? He's going to climb right up on that table. Oh, ball in hand. Ball in hand, and this rack is going
Davenport
to go to
Davenport. Ball in hand.
You know what he done there, Nicky? He took the value of the shot over the disability of having to shoot it left-handed. The shot just had so much more value playing it that way that he just decided to go ahead and shoot it left-handed.
Now, is this as big a lock as I think it is? Will Davenport just run these four on him now?
He should, yeah.
Yeah.
He should just run right out. I don't know what he's doing here.
He's drawing back.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
I tell you what, he got a little bit in trouble with that draw shot.
Well, I would have played it over in the opposite corner anyway. Then all he's got to do is just stop his ball for the seven. I mean, he's not thinking there.
Well, can't he make that six and still stop the ball right there for the seven?
Well, yeah, but now he's got to work.
He may have to go three rails for the seven.
Got to make the six first, which apparently is not that big a chore. All right. Yeah, he's going three rails.
He's hit it great.
Come
great
on, a little
speed.
More.
No, great
that's
speed.
It right there. Yeah.
That's a pretty shot, too.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect angle.
Now the nine ball. So Reyes tried something that not even he could pull off. And Davenport takes advantage of it and takes a 6-4 lead in the race to 11. You're watching. Can't believe that Reyes did that.
No, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to talk over the top of you. I can't believe that he played that five the way he did.
Reyes comes out now for the break. He's down 6-5, and he's moved the cue ball over on the far side, trying to get a little change in venue and a little better action. He broke the rack magnificently in his victory over Steve Mizerak. He gets one ball in the corner, and
he almost scored with disaster there.
Mm.
And he is snookered, but
I believe he's okay here.
Yeah.
He's got a couple of options here.
Would he have to cut the one ball back in the corner up on top?
Right.
Yeah.
Right. You either draw it or you follow it down behind two reels behind the seven. He's going to go two reels down behind the seven.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Really dangerous. He pulls off shots that. He makes them look just ordinary.
He's really in a predicament here. He's got to watch this point. This is the ball that he has to play position on right here. He really got his work cut out for him. Oh, man, he hit it great.
Didn't he?
Oh, what a nice touch.
Mm-hmm. Now he's already got the three ball set, and he's checking the rest of the table to find out where he's going next. 3 and the 4 aren't a problem, are they?
No, but the 4 to the 5 could be.
Yes, he's a long way away, but what does he do now with it? Put the 4 in the corner up there and then bring it all the way down to the 5, huh?
Either brings it all past the 7 or above the 7. I don't know which he's going to do.
Very nice. Very nice. Where will he get position for the 6? Where's he gonna? Right there? You can get it by the 9, huh?
Yep, same pocket.
No problem?
No problem. He just pull it back a little bit and shoot and stop, shoot and stop.
Yeah. Makes easy work of it, doesn't he? He's gonna tie this matchup at 6 games apiece. EFREN REYES. And now the 9 ball across the table in the corner, and just that quickly, he has erased a 6-4 deficit. And deadlock now, it's 6-all. What a great match we've got, this title affair for the Pro Tour Championship. We're in Owensboro, Kentucky. Deadlock, REYES and Davenport at 6 apiece. Davenport's the defending champ. Defending his title is not an easy thing. We'll be back. All right, tied at 6. REYES again for the break. He's had some recent success there.
Nothing.
And he came up empty this time, and I believe he's going to leave
a shot.
Davenport with a shot.
He does have a shot. I don't know if the 2 will pass by the 4. If it won't, then he'll have to go all the way down table and play the 2 on the side.
Scott Smith, the referee, okay,
here's the one
offering
ball
the bridge.
In right here. This is the 2 ball. If it'll pass here, then he'll probably play the cue ball in this line. But if that's not a possibility, then he'll play it straight back down table to this area to play the 2 in the side.
For me, you got to have a real touch right here to get that 1. Very deliberate with this. Nicely done. Beautifully done. Brings it back down to the position for the 2. Put that in the side pocket now, Willie.
Yep. Looks like it.
Or is he banking it? I think he might be banking it.
Boy, he didn't bank it. He drilled it. Nick, he drilled
that. That's what
that
you call a slam dunk here.
Boy, isn't it? I mean, if that if the pocket hadn't been there, to turn the whole side of that table out with that.
I tell you, these guys could wade in alligators. They've got lots of courage. They can play. They don't mind hitting the ball hard if that's what it takes.
What's he going to do about position on the 4?
He's just going to come on the right side of the 5 off that end rail with a little bit of right English on the cue ball.
He hit it with the inside.
He'll come back down 4, and then he's got to go back up for the 5. The 6 is up at that end as well.
And I don't see any problems. All he's got to do is stay in line.
Yeah, he'll just come down table and play the 4 ball in the same pocket he just played the 3 ball in.
Oh. Why did he went the opposite direction across table.
Must have been worried about hitting the 7 or something.
What does he do for the 6 now?
Just force it. Force it over.
Very nice, beautiful. Looks like he has a big chance to run this rack and take a 7-6 lead. Boy, this title match is every bit as advertised. Seesawing back and forth, neither man able to get more than a 2-game advantage over the other. But neither man can afford the luxury of making a mistake. When they do, they end up paying for it.
Right.
$15,000 goes to the winner, $7,500 to second place. So you got room?
Oh, yeah. He just put 1 rail out, playing both in the same 20. Pocket. Mm-hmm.
Beautiful. But he's getting all worked up over here, Nick. We're headed down the wire. All right. 7-6 now in favor.
It looked like he let up on the stroke just a little bit there.
Davenport goes on top, 7-6 in the race to 11. And the tension begins to mount. And now the nerves will start to take over a bit here as we go along, and every man knowing don't dare make a mistake, a bad play.
Well, buddy, it looks like we could possibly have 11-10 on our hands.
Yes, we could.
Well, another hill game.
Davenport makes a habit of those things. There you go.
Nine ball. Made it.
Look at the smile, huh?
Yeah, you like that one.
Boy, what's to hate when that nine ball goes silent? Boy, watch this again. And what a great shot we had of that rack. And watch it now from afar. And look at that nine ball just headed toward that lower right-hand corner. And, hey, it made it again, even on the replay, fellas. Well, it's now 8-6 in favor of Kim Davenport, who's trying to defend his Pro Tour title. Nick Varner's already got the real estate book out, got a little property he wants to show him. We can build a nice little house, move down here to Kentucky.
Nicky might have a farm or two he could sell him anyway.
Sure. Name the tournament after him, huh? Hang his picture up over at Dad's pool hall. Boy, Nick's got all kinds of things going now. He's thinking about here's Davenport again trying to make that nine ball again.
Yeah, let's see what happens.
It's got a better. Chance, got oh. a chance.
Oh, he got a shot.
Yep. And look where he's got that one ball.
He's got a shot.
Oh, boy.
I predict your shot before this game's over. Okay, he has the one ball right here.
What are you talking about?
He's playing position on the three right here. Yeah. I believe he'll play the cue ball one rail and back out here. The final shot.
Going to be the 6-9?
Is going to be the 6-9 combination.
Buddy Hall's got me all set. We can get down to the 6-9, boys. Just give it to me and stand back. I'll show you how to make that puppy.
I know one thing, what we'd call Tom if he played this game, his nickname would be Combination Tom.
That's right. That's his nickname anyway, whether he's going to play it or not.
That's what we're talking about, that 6-9. But we got to make the 3 before we can get around to me shooting that 6-9. Well, I'll tell you this. If Davenport doesn't do it, you give it to Reyes and he'll do it.
I think Kim's going to do it. He played for the angle.
Yeah. Four ball.
Played for the angle. He just go one rail up and down, boys. He just played one rail, I believe. You think he'll play it one rail, Nick, or you think he'll draw it?
Yeah, he's kind of on the borderline. He's going a little bit toward the 7. He may have to draw out of there, I think.
You did
no,
see
No, he's going forward. He's going forward, like you said, buddy.
You did see him go over there and eyeball that 6-9, though, didn't
he's
you?
He's drawn it.
Yeah.
Yeah. I believe he's drawn it.
No, he did change his mind.
Right there. Right there. There you are. I mean, are we lined up just a slight angle here? Not seriously, how tough is that combination?
Well, it's not very tough.
I like him shooting this one.
Yeah.
You do, huh?
Yeah. He's...
Do you like him making it?
Yes.
Yeah. I think that's a Kelly lock right there. Hello.
Oh, he hit the outside.
Lord.
I think he hit that a little too hard. I would have never hit that ball that hard.
Why would he shoot that? You're right.
I think he shot. Why did he shoot that hard?
Oh, I don't know.
I can't believe he played. I don't believe he hit the outside of the nine.
Boy, that nine ball looked like it was done. Okay,
he cut the 6 too much.
How can he hit the outside of that ball? You don't shoot that shot hard.
And he's over there talking to himself. He'd break a cue if he... Oh, boy.
Boy, what a big game that was for him.
Well, could have gone up 10-6.
Yes, it could.
That could come back to haunt him there.
Reyes will put that 7 away in the 8.
I tell you what, he's going to have to shoot this opposite-handed and spin it in. We're going to see a left-handed spin shot here.
Boy,
I can't believe Kim shot that shot like that.
What's he going to do with this?
He's going to spin it in left-handed, I think.
You mean he's going to bring it back down the other end? Or put it in that corner?
We killed it opposite-handed. What kind of stroke was that, buddy? That was a pretty powerful stroke.
Wow.
It was free. Yeah, that was a powerful stroke.
And now the nine ball, and Kim Davenport looks over and says, how could I have left that for him? How could I have given this guy a chance?
Oh, what a big opportunity Kim let get away. As it is, he still leads, but it's 8-7 now, and it could have been 9-6 in the race to 11. What a tough battle this is. Reyes is down by one, but he'll be coming on now with the break on the Pro Tour Championship. Reyes with the break. Games are tied at 8-all. Race to 11.
He made one?
Yep.
Hit the point, he got a shot.
Yep. So Reyes...
he has a problem here. I don't know if the one ball will pass here, then he may be able to play the cue ball down this side. This is the two ball right here. If he doesn't have either one of those options, he'll probably play the cue ball to right here. He'll probably play safe if he doesn't have that option. All right, what he did have.
Yeah.
He just underhit it. Too soft.
He didn't give himself any kind of a shot at that two ball. He's going to have to come off the rail, I think, to hit it. Deadlocked at 8 games apiece now. Big moment in this match for the title was when Davenport had a 6-9 combination and cut the 6 too much. He was leading 8 games to 6, could have been 9-6. Instead, it went to 8-7. And then Reyes came on to win and make it 8-8. And so it is deadlocked and pressure-packed now in the race to 11 as Reyes walks around the table eyeballing that two ball. Going to have to come off the rail to hit it, does he?
Right. You know, he may have a shot, actually have a shot at the two ball here. If he can get underneath it just a little bit, he may be able to kiss the two off of the four into the corner pocket.
Well,
he'll kick two real solid into the two.
He was looking into the crowd as if to seek help from Rolando or some of the members of the Filipino national team or his fellow countrymen. But we'll see how he does, buddy.
He tried that.
Yeah,
he got lucky.
Look at that. Look at that. Look what I found. Look what I found. I've played golf with guys who do that.
Not trying to say they maybe chip one in once in a while.
Oh, I mean, from behind a tree, it's a rock. Falls in, and the guy says, boy, I couldn't have played it any better. By that time, you want to take his wedge and just bury it inside his shirt.
You play the three in, play the cue ball to this area right in here, and then play the billiard on the 8 for this corner pocket.
What about the combination, buddy?
I don't think so. The combination's not that good. He'll play the billiard.
Think the billiard instead of the combination.
He wants to try to lag the four right to the rail.
Well, that is beautifully done. I mean, the man can play this game without any effort. He makes that 8 ball and just rolls, huh?
I believe that combination is going to come back to haunt Kim.
Boy, isn't that a shame. Here's Reyes now looking to take a lead for one of the few moments in this match. And now he comes down for the 9 ball to take a lead of 9-8. He was down 8-6, might have been down 9-6, and he's fought his way back now to take a lead of 9-8, just like that. Oh, boy. Yep. Davenport had that 6-9 combination and came up empty on it. He cut it too much and rattled that 9 ball. As a result, boy, from 8-6, it went to 8-7, 8-8, and now Reyes takes a lead of 9-8. Yes, again now, leading 9-8. What an important rack this is. What an important break. And he's going to have a shot at the one ball after all that, huh?
Yes, a shot at the three. He's got a shot at going, getting to the hill first.
Oh, that's right. I'm looking at the five, thinking it was the one. Gets to the five, he's liable to play a combination, length of 9.
That's a real good chance of that. You like those? Where you pick those combinations out pretty quick here.
Pick them out. He starts looking for them as soon as the rack's broke.
Yeah. The guy said, didn't come in to get a haircut. Let's gamble now. Let's get at you. Boy, you know, I hate to harp on it, but you're right. That combination 6-9, the Davenport, boy, that may just be.
We have seen it.
I'm sorry.
Oh, go ahead, buddy.
Just trying to come across.
Here it comes. Here it comes. You're looking at it now. 5-9 to go up 10-8. Boy, I tell you. There it is. He leads 10-8. Though this kid is tough. If he gets a chance, don't count him out. Davenport was down, remember, in that semifinal, 9-2 and 10-5. But he's got to get a break from Reyes, and Reyes now has a chance to break him again. He leads 10-8, and this is break point and championship. Scott Smith, the referee, racks him up. Reyes eyeballs the rack. Davenport just looking on. Let me tell you something. That cue ball just did a dance in there. It looked as though I wouldn't have been surprised he'd pop out. Well, all right. Kim, you've got a big time chance right here. Let's see if you can do it now. You're down 10-8. Reyes has run off three straight games on you.
He's got a shot here. I believe he's going to play the one right here. Stop his cue ball right there where this ball's at, so he can play this ball in and come to this area for position on the three. No, he played it down below.
Okay.
That's perfect. That's perfect angle.
Nick says he likes it. Now Buddy says he likes it. Put it up in the corner.
Looks like he's got to be a little careful on the...
What he is, though, gentlemen, is in a position where he cannot make a mistake.
We've seen him in that one before.
Yes, and he has been equal to the task. Now, he's got that three-ball position nicely, and the 5, 6, 7. He has every availability to run this table here and get right back into this. But he can't make a mistake.
No, he has to play solid pool from here on out.
Right there. 5, take it up for the 6 and 7. He's trailing 10-8.
Something to bridge up on, but not careful.
Boy, it got quiet in here all of a sudden, didn't it? Huh?
Well, we're getting down to the...
That's right.
To the short strokes. This match.
Oh, what a beautifully played position on that. If he makes the 9, the plot thickens. So Davenport gets an opportunity and takes advantage of it. The match is at 10-9. Davenport will break in an effort to try to tie it. He's the defending champion. We'll be back. Here we go. Davenport now to break. Needs to make a ball here. Needs to run this rack to bring it to 10 even.
Boy, he hits him hard.
Came up empty.
Came up dry. Drive. I don't think he has a shot, though.
What about cutting that one in this upper corner, buddy, and swinging around two rails for the two?
Wait.
Then it's over.
He may not have to do that. He may be able to play the one all the way down and just bump this rail and come back out. This is the two right here.
Oh, okay. That's what he's doing.
No, he's playing safe. He's ducking.
Oh, he ducked.
Boy.
He's ducking.
Wow.
Protecting that one game, isn't he?
Well, he does have that one game advantage. He can afford to have this game go away, and he still would be no worse than dead even, even though Kim would have the break. But he does have that advantage.
I believe I'd have had to shoot if I had a shot.
Oh, I think
take
so,
it off.
Too. As good as he can play, I don't think that was a tough shot, that one ball in the corner.
No, he's very capable of making that shot. Yeah.
Plus, he'd have had that cue ball back up where the two is. And tough shot for Davenport. Missed it. Well, maybe the strategy is going to be 100% now for Reyes. He has a ball in hand.
He may play the nine ball here, huh? No.
Now you're getting to talk like that announcer Kelly in combinations and all that.
You got me tricked up.
I did that trick you right into that.
Yeah, you're talking like Combination Kelly.
That's right. Reyes is looking that over. I don't know. Let's not throw that thought away too soon.
Do you see any problem here, buddy?
I don't. I think it's a lock now.
I think all he's got to do is make sure he gets on the three. And just Katie bar the door.
Mm-hmm.
You don't want to get behind the four.
Oh,
golly.
You know, before he shot that, I was thinking I might hit that with just a hair or a reverse and stay on that side.
He could have followed it.
That's what I meant.
Yeah.
And Reyes had the look on his face of, I can't believe I did that. And he looked into the crowd as if to say, that wasn't me. What happened here?
They're from smiling on the outside and crying on the inside.
That's right. Boy, I guess there are no locks, huh? There are no certainties. He has made some marvelous shots, though. Done some tremendous... Are you kidding me? You know, he almost made that in the side.
Well, Kim's got a shot. That's a whole lot more than he had.
That's right, sitting down over there.
That's right.
I think that's important in this situation. You've got to take the attitude that it's you're just fortunate to be at the table one more time, even though he's in a tough position.
That's right. Count your blessings and make the most of it. Now, see, reach back for a little magic. This kid has been tough. Inside, he's been very tough. Defending champion.
This is a hard shot.
Yeah, especially elevating up like that. Look out.
Nine ball.
Oh. He almost locked the nine in.
I thought it was going for a second.
I did. So did the crowd. Kim looked at it as if to say, how about that? What happened? Well, what about Reyes now, gentlemen? He's got a shot at the three, hasn't he?
He's got to make sure he gets a shot at the four. He'll ever try to hit the four square from behind. Or maybe he's going to just spin it out there.
He wouldn't try to make that nine ball with some kind of a... All right.
Is he going to slice this one in the corner, buddy?
Well, he shot one down in the corner here a while back.
Didn't he?
That was a lot tougher than this one.
He's magnificent at these thin little cut shots.
The second thought on that, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Ever.
Mm-hmm.
I prefer, actually, this shot here, the way it's laying, to bank it.
Well, let me tell you. You know, you can't, I don't care how good he is, he can't make a mistake. That nine ball's just hanging there. That's a Kelly nine ball right there. Yeah. Just hanging, waiting. Can't make a mistake.
I think he's looking at your shot on the bank, huh?
I think he should shoot at the bank.
Davenport is hoping he makes a mistake so that he can get back up there. It's 10-9 in favor of Reyes.
That's the shot I like right there.
Can he make the five in that corner?
Well, it has a pocket, but I would have played position. I wouldn't have played the safety. He built the safety into it with a six. I would have went ahead and played position. I wouldn't have ducked. I would have been shooting.
Wow. Hit that ball good.
Yeah.
Yep. That was a great shot there.
I think it's over, gentlemen.
We thought that earlier, didn't we?
Yes, but I really do think this is over, unless he does something really uncharacteristic and buries the cue ball behind the eight or something, I don't think.
Yeah. Look at him.
Kim just sits there and thinks.
He's going to come across on the short side, isn't he?
Yeah, I think so.
So it's come down to this. The eight ball and the nine ball just hanging there. Now the nine ball. Reyes makes that. He's the Pro Tour champion. Just like that. So Efrem Reyes outlasts Kim Davenport, whose title defense was unsuccessful. What a great match, though. 11-9. Davenport had his chances, and Reyes just wouldn't give up when he got his opportunities. He's around shaking hands with everybody and $15,000 richer. We'll be back to talk to the champion and the ex-champion in just a moment. Well, it was a magnificent tournament, and it came down to a great championship final match. And the champ almost made it two in a row, and we'll get to you in a moment, Kim. Nick, your hometown treated us just fine and had a great tournament.
Oh, it's been a thrilling week. We really had a great time having the Pro Billiards Tour here in Owensboro, Kentucky.
Yeah, and Buddy, you were saying it would have been great if Nick had been there for the title go, huh?
It would have been.
You didn't really say
wonderful.
That, but we were both thinking that.
It would have been wonderful, yes.
What a treat it was to work with you two guys. Thank you so much for your great coverage, and I look forward to doing it again. Now we come to the man who wanted to be king twice in a row. Kim, you were so close. You were up 8-6 and could have gone 9-6, and you missed a big combination play, and you'll be thinking about that for a while, won't you?
I probably will be thinking about it for a while, but, you know, anytime you have two champions playing, it's very tough. You're gonna win some tournaments, you're going to lose some tournaments, and Efrem is a great player, so, hey, that's the way it goes.
Well, listen, we're going to make it just a little bit sweeter because His Honor the Mayor, Mr. Morris of Owensboro, has got not only a nice pen there for you, but a beautiful check. Mr. Mayor, if you will.
Kim, we want to congratulate you. And even though you didn't repeat, you came very close. And I want to congratulate you and say we're pleased to have you in Owensboro along with Mr. Reyes. And we think you put on a fine championship game. Congratulations.
Indeed. That $7,500 will make it just a little bit sweeter, so there's nothing wrong with that. And thank you for a magnificent performance. We come to the champion, and I must say, when I told Reyes, I said, boy, what a great win. He said, I was a little lucky. And I tell you, his English got very good, and it's going to get a lot better because Mr. McDaniels of AMF has got a big check for him, if you will, sir.
I have a nice check for Mr. Reyes, and I'd like to thank Mr. Reyes and the whole Pro Billiards Tour. And on behalf of all the employees at AMF Playmaster, I am also willing to present this clock to him as well.
That's beautiful.
Thank you.
Thank
great
you, Doug.
Thank
congratulations
you.
Again, Efren. You may be the best player in the world, bar none. He certainly is in the Philippines, isn't he, Rolando? I'm sure he is around the world. Well, that takes care of it. We've had a great time here in Owensboro, Kentucky. And next will be the Nine Ball World Championship from Winston-Salem, North Carolina.